now and send as much love, energy, prayer, whatever you believe in, to his family and to the other families that were affected by this tragedy. But I also want to take a moment that I want us to remember how precious life is and the opportunities we get. And that if you're here in this gym, it's because parents love you and they want to see you become great and they want to see you be inspired to all these amazing things. And I want us to take those moments and realize we cannot take those things for granted. And I feel like if there's anything that's frustrating about this generation, is how much you take things for granted. You really do. We take a lot of things in this world for granted. And now it's rare when I find a kid that doesn't, that like actually like enjoys every opportunity they get. And I think Kobe Bryant and everyone else's death, and the fact that I think the most painful thing is that how much he loved his watching his children play sports. And it's just like all of your parents back there love watching you play sports. Don't take it for granted. And I was thinking like that, honestly, I really didn't, I was like so sad, I couldn't stop crying, I was sick in my stomach. But I thought, what is the way I could honor Kobe? Because I think the saddest part is he doesn't get to watch his daughter become the WNBA player she was bound to become. He doesn't get to watch her do any of those like things. And I thought, how do I honor him? How do I honor him? How do I honor that? How do I honor that as a parent? How do I honor that as a daughter? Like I sit here and think, you can see in Gigi's eyes how much she believed in herself and how great she wanted to be and how she wanted to go to UConn and how she wanted to be a WNBA player. And you can see that her dad was like, I'm going to make women's sports awesome. Like, this was his next chapter in life. Like, he was like, I already did me. Now it's my turn to do this for my daughters. I mean, just last week, we watched him cheer on his daughter playing volleyball. You know, he gave little Amani a cupcake. And I just sit here and think, just like the next week, he's gone. Just like that. And now that little girl doesn't get a chance to even pursue the dreams that she's so passionate about going after. Yet, we are all in this gym. Getting the opportunity to continue to pursue our dreams, how are you doing it? Are you doing it as passionate as they were? I'm going to tell you, some of you are and some of you aren't. And I think, gosh, how do we honor like an entire family that just got completely gone from their daughter that just was staying at home sleeping? And woke up and found out her, like all her family, but her brother in college is gone. How do we honor Kobe, who taught us how to have a good mentality? How do we honor Gigi, who was doing everything she could in every way she could to become an amazing basketball player? How do we honor that? And I'm telling you, the way we honor that, we can't ever forget it, that what we have is a gift. If we can't let life become so redundant, clock in, clock out, we've got to make sure that every day we realize that this is a gift, and I'm going to give 100 to this gift. I'm going to give 100 to my relationships. I think like when I see him, I think of Kobe growing up, it's like, he just gave 100 to everything he did. Like, it's not even a surprise that he was the amazing NBA player that he was, right? But it's not a surprise that like a year later he wanted to have a new one. Because I always tell like my kids, if you want to be great, it's not about like bouncing the ball on the 10-foot line. It's not about having $1 billion in your name. It's literally about giving 100% to every detail of your life, to your relationships, to your friendships, to your family, to making your bed in the morning, to brushing your teeth, to washing your face. Like, those might seem like little things that we just kind of like, oh, I don't need to do that, or I don't need to make my bed. But if we practice giving 100 to making our bed, and practice giving 100 taking care of our bodies, and practice 100 giving like friendships and practice a hug and saying, thank you, Mom, I appreciate this. Thank you, Dad, for this. Please, can I have this? Or can I talk to you about something? And being polite, we give 100 to all this. And then we wake up and we work hard and we do extra workouts and we're doing everything like they did. Then are you going to be successful?
Yes.
You are. You are going to be successful. It is not the most talented person that wins the race. It is literally the hardest worker in the gym, at school, anything that wins the race. And maybe you won't make the Olympics, okay? But maybe you giving 100 to your sport, to your family, to making your bed, to taking care, to being responsible, to always checking yourself. Maybe you like won't become an Olympian volleyball player, or even a D1 or D2 or D3 volleyball player. You never know. But I will tell you, you will succeed at something if we spend your entire life giving 100. Because those are habits. And what did Kobe have? He had great habits. We're coming together, and on the 17 and under division, we're gonna wear an arm band representing that has 8, 24, and 2, because Gigi was 2. And we're gonna wear that because his daughter plays in the 17 and under division. And we're gonna honor that. But like, the way to really honor him is to not take life for granted, to not let take these opportunities for granted, and to give 100% to our life. Don't let lazy come in the door. The minute you allow lazy to come into your life, lazy loves to sit there on a couch and take over your life. You have to fight lazy. You have to learn to give up your life. So the way we can honor them is never take life for granted. Never take your loved ones for granted. Never take your parents for granted. Listen, we are not perfect people. Parents are not perfect. And when you become teenagers, you start realizing that more. But they are doing everything they can to love you, support you, and give everything they can, even through all their flaws. Do you understand? And you respect that, and you give them, you thank them for those moments, and you thank them for bringing you this. Does everyone understand? And give 100 to your life. That's how we can honor. Not just writing a number. Writing a number is great because maybe it'll always remind you, hey, you're feeling sorry for yourself. Just work harder. Don't give up on yourself. Get back in the gym. Don't forget to do this 100% today. Maybe that writing this number will remind you to give 100 to your life or to appreciate what you have in front of you. But like, my biggest thing is that let's honor him by the way we live the rest of our lives, you know? When life knocks you down, let's get back up on the horse. Let's keep fighting to get to stand back up. Okay? It's Supernova. Yeah.